making a plan for the rest of the day, why I am not able to complete my task despite of my
Akash, how many of us does it happen that we make grand plans but are rarely able to make them? So for sure, it is not this question alone. It is a question that belongs to several of us. In fact, each single one of us. So why does that happen? Let's try to investigate. Here on top, you want to go to sleep and you discover that you either need to read in the morning to come to your life and you need to study, or you find that you're getting overweight or underweight or whatever, and you feel that in the morning time you need to hit the gym or go and have a game of soccer. So you set your alarm for 5 a.m., right? At 11 p.m. in the night, there is this fellow who has made a resolution, who has decided something, okay? There's a sense of awareness that he decides that in the morning at 5, I'll get up. Now what happens at 5 in the morning? The fellow is sleepy, drowsy. And what does he do? The brain is ready. Comfortably continue sleeping. Comfortably keep continuing sleeping. What happens? At 7 a.m. he gets up. Gets up quite leisurely. And then he repents. Another day off. And then there is that feeling of guilt and suffering. It was the same fellow who was resolving at 11 in the night, then the same fellow who put down the alarm at 5 in the morning and the same fellow who is repenting at 7 in the morning. Why does it happen so? Happens this way because it is not the same man. We are deluded into thinking that it is the same person who is doing all these three things. It is in fact three different people. We are not one, we are a crowd. Because we are dictated by our mind, and mind is composed of thousands of external influences. So at 11, there is an external influence, there is a teacher that invited you something or your friends have made you a call and you decide that I want to sleep. That is one external influence. At 5, the body is genuine. Then there is no need of resolutions. If you just see a fire here, then you need to make a resolution. I resolve that I will get out of this room. You just get out. If you really know, where is the need for resolutions? Just act, spontaneous action. But because we never have knowledge, we only have influences upon us. Hence our actions are never spontaneous. That is the reason why we are always craving for guidance. Somebody else must come and tell us a few things to do. Why? Because I have no internal knowledge of my own. Internally I am sleeping, so I always need other people. Have you ever wondered why there is that constant craving within us to talk to somebody? Have you ever wondered why we cannot remain alone even for a little while? Have you ever wondered why we start feeling so awkward if somebody is capable of remaining alone and we start calling him a loner? Have you ever wondered that even in the moments when you are listening, why there is that internal voice that is singing a song? It is because you are desperate for something to fill your inner void. There is a great void here, and you are always craving for somebody or something from outside to come over and fill that void. Once the desire is really yours, you will find that it is just fulfilled. It does not even need time to be fulfilled. Once you understand, then from that, real action will occur, and that occurs right now. That is not even a desire for the future. That is not time dependent. It happens right now. If you want to test, if you want to genuinely test whether something is really worth doing or not, then there is one simple rule of thumb for that. If it is about the future, then it is false. If whatever you are desiring, whatever you are resolving, is something that can find completion only in the future, then whatever you are desiring or resolving is definitely false. There is no doubt about that. And the funny part is, there is nothing that you desire for this moment. You always desire for the next one. Hence, the conclusion of statement A and B is that all your desires are false. Which is a little scary, I suspect. Your life runs on desires. If I take away desires from you, you will collapse.